So good evening, everyone. Welcome. Again, my name's Joe Cox, and I have the pleasure of serving as Museum of Discovery and Science's president and CEO. So as we saw, we've got someone from Staten Island. So I shouldn't assume, but we are in Fort Lauderdale, Florida tonight, where it is lovely and warm. What we're going to go do this evening is share some of the really exciting news that we have about the Museum of Discovery and Science education programs. So as we do, feel free as we go through to put any questions that you have in the chat, and we'll be monitoring those and answering them as we go through. But we've got a lot going on. Eric's gonna show me the timeline for this evening on the next slide. So we're gonna kick things off with some introductions to our team. And then we're really going to drill down into our programs. You know, as we are used to here at the museum, welcoming hundreds of thousands of people through our doors. And while you can certainly still come for a visit, we've got a whole new range of INSPIRE programs. Remember that word, INSPIRE. I'll say it one more time. Remember that word, INSPIRE. We've got a whole new range of programs where we can actually come out to you virtually. So a little bit more about that. We're also going to talk about how you book a program. How do you sign up for teacher membership, an educator membership? And then at the very end this evening, we're going to show you an IMAX trailer. While we have an incredible IMAX theater here at the museum, if you're not able to visit us, we can actually stream an IMAX movie directly to you in your classroom or to your student screens. And those prizes. So we have some wonderful prizes to give away at the end this evening. So please stick around till the end. Now to introduce our educators, you're gonna hear from four great members of our education team this evening. Missy, who's our early childhood STEM educator, is going to be giving you a great tour of our brand new Sprouting STEM Early Learning Lab, powered by PNC's Grow Up Great program. Becky Gold, our STEM Center manager, is going to dig into all kinds of programs that we have and really explore our INSPIRE program. Brady is our public programs coordinator, and Brady's someone who you might see if you book one of our programs or if you visit museum. And then controlling the entire evening is Eric, and Eric is one of our incredible STEM teachers who presents our programs and this evening is driving the bus, so thank you, Eric. You're also going to hear at the end of the evening from our deputy director, Meredith, who's going to go into details about how you book your program. So with that, I think I am turning it over to Becky. Oh, prizes, yes, prizes. I get to do prizes, then I'll turn it over to Becky. So this evening, we're going to ask you some questions at the end of the presentation. If you guess those questions correctly, and the way we're going to do this is we're going to just have you write them down in the chat, you could win a virtual program for your learners. We will deliver one of our virtual programs direct to you. You could win some Hollywood IMAX tickets. You could win a wonderful mystery box from our Explore store. You could win a maker activity kit. Or one of our animals from the museum would love to visit you virtually, and you could have that delivered to your learners. So, really excited about these programs, really excited about bringing them to you. So with that, I will now turn it over to Becky.
All right, so I get to talk about all of the fun things that we're doing here at the museum, both virtually and in person. So we've developed a new program and it's called INSPIRE, Innovative STEM Programs in Remote Education. So we're very excited that we can come to your classroom or an assembly or on Teams or on Zoom to be with you and your learners in a remote setting. And we have some great options of how to do that. And the great thing about Inspire programs is that a live educator is with you. So if your learners have questions, we can answer them right away. For some of these, you'll see that we have kits and other things that we can actually assist your learners in putting some things together. So let's delve a little deeper. We have four types of Inspire programs. The first one is called Inspire Kit, and this is a lab program. So we will deliver some science experiments. It could range from all different things from slime making to we're gonna see our owl pellet dissection kit. One of my favorite activities here at the museum is making. And making is when you get to have a problem and you get to kind of come up with your own innovative solution. It really helps with problem solving, imagination, all kinds of things that we're trying to do. Go ahead, Eric. You can take a tour of our museum floor. Just because you can't come in person doesn't mean that you can't come and experience the museum. And I have a treat with our new staff member who's going to lead you on that tour. And finally, we have Inspire Connect. And these programs are more of a demo nature, or maybe have a printable so that there would be nothing you have to do but book this program, and we will be streamed live into your classroom and right there to interact with your learners. This could be an animal encounter, or we're gonna show you an example. So I think Eric's gonna lead us off with Inspire Connect. Get a little taste of what one of these programs would look like.
Hi, everybody. So, yep, just like Becky said, I'm here to give you guys a taste of one of our Inspire Connect programs, and it's called Coral Reef Rangers. It is a program all about coral reefs, what they are, why they're important, and what are some of the threats they're facing nowadays, and what we can do to help. And it's designed for grades 6 to 12, though, as with a lot of our programs, these can be adapted to a bunch of different grade levels. So I'm just gonna give you guys a quick snapshot of this. It's usually a 45-minute program, but we're gonna try and get through this in about 5 minutes. So just an example of one of the slides that I came up with for your learners. It's just a little bit of a big picture kind of thing where we tell them that even though corals are tiny and they're made up of these tiny little organisms called polyps, they actually make some of the biggest and most important structures on Earth. We illustrate that the Great Barrier Reef is probably the largest natural structure on Earth, one of the seven natural wonders of the world, and it's so big that you can't even see it from space, and that's why I put this picture here. And this is just a bit of terminology showing them that corals come in all shapes and sizes, and that there are two main kinds, and the ones that we're really concerned about are the ones that have tentacles in multiples of six, or hexacorals. And these are the ones that actually build the heart reefs that we see that provide all these benefits to not just us, but a lot of different animals. Now, just to hammer home to kids that coral is really important for a bunch of animals, what we like to do in a lot of our outreaches is always have some sort of interactive component, even if it's an online lecture like this, just to kind of foster more engagement. Because as we all know, science should be hands-on, minds-on, and this is a great way to engage them. So what this game is basically a very simple but effective game, and we like to call it the zoom out game, where we show you a extremely zoomed in image and then we kind of bring it out a little bit while you guys guess what it is. So what's gonna happen here is I'm gonna show you an image of an animal that's really zoomed in and you guys can try to guess what it is. So if you have it, don't blur it out in chat or Zoom, just kind of keep it to yourself. All right, so what's this? Guesses? You can put guesses in chat, it's okay. All right, coral. Thanks, Nicole. Nicole, warmer. All right, what about now? Parrotfish, fish, good, good. Not exactly a parrotfish. I'm just waiting for somebody to say the character name. There you go, Nina, thank you. It is Dory. So Dory is actually part of a special kind of fish called the regal tang, and it's one of the most iconic species of coral reef fish that we see here. Actually, I don't know if it's named in Florida. I'll have to look that up. But basically, the regal tang is one of the most prolific fishes on coral reefs, and it's really important. I use this as a really good example because everybody recognizes Dory just like Nina did. And it's a really good example because you can tell a lot of things about this fish. It relies on the coral reef for both protection and food. That's why its body's kind of compressed. It goes into all those nooks and crannies to hide from big predators. And I can also talk about how Dory over here is super brightly colored because that's something coral reef fishes have in common to tell each other apart. All right, so you guys killed it on that last game. Let's see if you guys can guess the next animal. All right, spoiler alert, it's not the fish. Something bigger than the fish. Yep, you guys guessed it. It's a sea turtle, and in fact, is a green sea turtle. As a side note, we're gonna say goodbye to our resident loggerhead turtle on Monday. So if you guys want to send any cards or farewell gifts his way, we'll send them right to him. We had our kids come up with some things of what to send him, and apparently some of them wanted fishing rods and stuff. So we're gonna send George a little care package. But anyway, back to our green sea turtle. So why are green sea turtles, why are coral reefs important to them? And the reason is not only do they rely on coral reefs for food, such as algae, they also come to coral reefs as sort of a car wash type of deal. So what they do, the green sea turtles come here, and that's what all these fish are doing. They're picking off little dead skin, parasites, all these things that green sea turtles want to get rid of so that they can remain to live to 150 years or more. And it's a really cool phenomenon to watch. It's a great example of how animals on a coral reef work together for each other's benefit. And what's really cool is these green sea turtles will actually line up in lines like humans trying to get in the car wash. That's what this guy in the back's waiting for. He's waiting for this guy to be done. All right, but yeah, that's basically all I have for you as a quick snapshot of our Coral Reef Rangers program. And now I will hand it back over to Becky to take us through one of our Inspire Labs kits offering. So, Becky?
All right. So, yes, we do have two types of Inspire Lab kits, and we can deliver, or you can pick up here. So the first one is Makerspace, and we're gonna go in a little bit later, something that's very exciting. We have a new vehicle coming to Mod, so I'll show you some pictures of that in a little bit. But making kits can be anything from slime to helicopters, to all kinds of different things that we've done, bridges, animal bridges, things like that. But the next thing that I'm gonna show you is one of our lab kits. So it would come in a nice little box or bag, just like this. And I know my kids love to unbox, so we're gonna unbox here. So when you look inside, wow, look at all the stuff that you get. All right, I'm gonna hold it close and try to get my virtual background to stay away. So in this baggie here is an owl pellet and a magnifying glass and some tweezers. So owls, as you can see in the second picture there, they're going to be a top level consumer. That means they're going to eat things like mice and shrews and other small birds. And then there are parts that they cannot digest. So if you look in the second picture, that is an owl coughing up or throwing up an owl pellet. And what's great for learners is to be able to look inside those owl pellets and discover what's inside. So what we have here are some great worksheets. I can turn them around. So one kind of describes it, but then as you're going through your owl pellet, you could figure out which animal it came to. And so for high schoolers, you're now not just talking about what's inside of an owl pellet, which is a cool activity, but you're looking at biodiversity, environmental health. Are you seeing one animal disappear from the owl pellets? That type of thing. And if you were in anatomy, what a fun way to maybe get an idea of the skeleton system. where you can then match up here on the mouse what kind of things you have here. So everything that your learners need will come in the kit. Let me get my kit back in order. And it comes all wrapped up, we'll deliver it, and then we get on Teams or Zoom with you, and we will help facilitate the use of this kit. So whether it's building something, dissecting things, mixing reactions, all of these are available. So this is a great way to get hands-on learning into your learners' hands. And that way that they're not just sitting there watching another lecture, they have things to do in front of them that are extra fun. So we have kits available for preschool through high school. We've worked to make sure that there are 27 different kind of offerings for virtual learners, because we know that you still want to have those fun field trips, even if they can't leave the school. So we can deliver a classroom set of these for you. So another great opportunity that we have are virtual tours. And we are excited to announce that we are getting a gyroscope iPad carrying robot. So if you can look in the picture there, it is gonna have your class's face on it. We're gonna give you a code and we're gonna let you drive this robot around our museum floor. So how much fun would it be for everyone to take a turn to see what they see? We can also provide a bingo sheet or some other kind of sheet like that where you can check off different things as they're looking. So maybe one learner is driving and another learner is checking things off on their bingo sheet so that everybody is engaged with these tours. We can go to, go ahead, Eric, and show the picture of Joe with it. Yep, so there you can see Joe's face is on it. He's using his phone, but you can also use any kind of tablet. You can raise and lower this robot, and it can visit almost any of our floor space. So until January, we have this great dinosaur experience, Expedition Dinosaur. So it's super fun. The dinos are interactive and they roar and they move, and you can definitely get into the history of paleontology, which if you've never studied is super cool and super interesting. You can come to our Powerful You experiments and look at all the body things and x-rays and things like that. We have our animals, so you can drive through our coral reef or past the alligators or even on down to our favorite, the otters. So all kinds of exploring is gonna happen using our new robot, and you guys get to do that. Maybe that's what you wanna choose if you happen to win the Inspire virtual tour. Go ahead, Eric, and I think we have one more picture. Is that true? Oh, so we thought we would give you kind of a taste of some of our tours and some of our demos that we could do using our brand new Camp Discovery videos. So we spent all summer here at the museum getting some videos going for YouTube, and you can find them there if you want to, or they are also linked on our website. But let's go ahead and look at a couple of these videos and see what kind of tours you could take.
Do it, let's get ready.
This experiment is called hydrogen bubbles. We are going to use hydrogen gas. We're actually going to infuse them into a bubbly solution. Hydrogen gas is not something that you can just go to the store and buy. No. This is something that you have to special order, and you have to be part of a science institution in order to have it, so good luck. Anyways, so we are going to actually right now just drain our hydrogen balloon right in to our liquid right over here. So here we go, as you can see, Lan is really getting the hydrogen gas in there. We are actually going to get our hands down in the water. We're gonna make sure our hands are coated, and then we're going to scoop up some of those bubbles, and then we're just gonna 3, 2, 1, and we're gonna light these and we're gonna watch what happens. Here we go, 3, 2, and 1. Well, that was absolutely crazy.
Yes, it was.
Well, we had a fourth experiment for you, but it went up in flames. But go ahead, stay tuned to the channel, comment, like, subscribe. We'll have plenty of more cool, fun science stuff for you in the upcoming weeks.
See you, folks.
Let's set sail into the Florida Everglades to meet a baby American alligator. Hey, welcome to the Museum of Discovery and Science. I'm Michael. I'm here in our Ecoscapes exhibit right outside the alligator hole. Some pretty cool animals inside of here. I just really wish I could see one up close and personal. Oh, wait.
Ooh. Did you call for personal experience?
I did. That was so crazy.
Here I am.
What are you holding?
This is Beast Boy. He is our baby American alligator.
He's really small. How old is he?
He is roughly between 3 and 6 months old.
That's fantastic. Where does he live?
He lives within the Everglades. He's a Florida native.
And the Everglades, it sounds kind of like an important spot.
Yes, it is one of the most important places in Florida and the world.
Why?
Well, the Everglades is one of the most diverse ecosystems on the planet, and it is the home to an abundance of different animals, and it is very important for where we get, us Floridians, get all our water.
And so the Everglades can be very hot, so
yes.
I assume it's dry all year long there?
No. Here in Florida, we have two seasons. We have the rainy season and we have the dry season.
And when are those?
Well, the dry season would be considered winter. That would be from November to April. And then the wet season would be from May to October.
Awesome. And so now I'm looking at this baby alligator, Beast Boy.
Beast Boy.
And he has some stripes on him. Why does he have those stripes?
Well, as he gets older, you might notice that adult alligators don't have these stripes. But as babies, he is very tiny. The Everglades is filled with abundance of animals he'd make a wonderful snack for.
Okay.
So these little stripes help him camouflage within the sawgrass and the reeds, so he is not easy pickings.
So camouflage is kind of like him playing hide and seek. Okay, yeah. Fantastic. And is he native to the Everglades?
Yes, he is. He's one of the keystone species of the Everglades.
Keystone species, that's a very big phrase. What does it mean?
A keystone species is essentially an animal in an ecosystem that determines and reflects the health of that ecosystem.
Awesome. And you said he was native, so the opposite of native, I'm going to assume, is non-native?
Non-native or invasive.
And what is an example of a non-native or invasive animal that might be in the Everglades, let's say, today?
One of the biggest threats to our little guy here and the Everglades as a whole is like the Burmese python.
But that's a snake. Don't we have snakes here?
Yes, we have our native snakes, but the Burmese python actually comes from Asia and India.
Oh, so they don't live here.
No, they can grow up to 20 feet long. And these alligators are supposed to be the biggest thing in the Everglades.
So, last question I want to ask you. He's croaking. Why is he croaking?
Well, alligators are typically raised by their mother for the first couple months of their life. He is croaking to call his mommy over.
Oh, okay. And does he ever call daddy?
No, dad is... does not play a role here.
Okay, fantastic. Well, thank you for that up close and personal experience with an American alligator. We'll see everybody next time on our YouTube channel.
All right, so all different kinds of things. So we have another brand new space here at the museum. It is our Sprouting STEM Lab, and we are going to go live now to the Sprouting STEM Lab and see everything wonderful that we are going to see there. And it's a new early childhood space. So Missy, are you there? No? No Missy? Well, I'll chat a little bit more about that. One of the things that I think you're familiar with is that the Museum of Discovery and Science is both a science museum and a children's museum. So we really wanted to focus on our little learners. And we built them a brand new space. So there, a lot of times our babies and toddlers had nowhere to come and interact with science here. And so we have this space now where they can be on that space and interact with some of our new toys. So there's a different way of observing, using your five senses, all of those things are great. We even offer a caregiver and me class that you can come with your young one and come into our room. We have interactive songs, we do a science experiment with them, even even at the little age, we can do the sign language of those rooms. So there they are. Oh, I see them. All right, so we're heading in.
Hello and welcome. My name is Missy. Welcome to the Grow Up Great Sprouting STEM Learning Lab. It's a mouthful, and it's powered by PNC. I get to play in this classroom every day, but the exciting part is I can bring it to you virtually or live. I've been going on outreaches to preschools, and I've been having a blast. I come in, I wear a mask, I wash my hands, and I follow all the protocols. I can bring you a demo, I can bring you a lab, and I can bring you something exciting called a family science night, something like I have set up tonight. This is our Mod Speedway. This is Stomp Rockets. The children make a rocket, and every child gets to make the rocket fly. And this is called Snap Circuits. So we bring snap circuits, and we bring enough for a classroom set, so all the children get to learn about snap circuits. And the thing is about this is they get to use their creativity and build things. We bring 15 centers to you. You give us some volunteers. We train the volunteers how to run it, and we run 15 exciting tables. So you can do it in your classroom. You can have a family science night at night. We can even do it on the weekends. We would love to come to your classroom. We do all sorts of family science nights. We do early childhood. We do life science, earth science, STEAM science, and physical science. And we would love to come to your classroom. So book us. All you do is go to booking@mods.net, and I can come and teach your children. Have a great night, everybody.
Wow. Thanks, Missy. That was an exciting thing to do, to come. And perhaps you didn't know that we can also have you come visit us. I think our deputy director would like to tell us a little more about how we can find out more. Oh, okay. We can go to Meredith, or I can tell you about the STEM-mobile. I'm so excited, I almost forgot. Our STEM-mobile is a brand new Nissan van that I am loading with the best science interactive things that I can find. I've got robots, I have circuit tools, I have things so we can solve global problem solving, and I have cool new tools. Things like a 3D printer, a Cricut, a CNC router, and I'm even getting a drone. So this van can come to you. We are very excited. And if you come from a Title I school, you can use your SEEDS grants, and we do have a few opportunities for some low-income learners to come and get the STEM-mobile. And we can set the STEM-mobile up outside. So if you're a little bit hesitant to have a visitor in the school, what if we came to the parking lot? Hey, Eric, do you have a picture of the parking lot set up? Look at that. So we're gonna come set up some tents and an awning, and we'll put the tables out. And we can have a recess one if you want, where kids can come and interact with our tables, and we can set up a robot petting zoo or perhaps a tool and drool. And during their recess, the learners can come up and have some hands-on what they think is play and we know is good learning going on. So this van is gonna come fully equipped with everything that it needs, from power to hands-on activities, to an audio system, and we may throw in a few bells and whistles. So I'm very excited to announce our new STEM-mobile, and it will be rolling out sometime mid-November. But if you happen to go and visit us at the haunt, you will see it there. All right, STEM-mobile, so exciting.
Okay, so now that Becky's done talking about the STEM-mobile, we're gonna go back to our original program, and I'm gonna have our deputy director, Meredith, talk to you a little bit more about how to book and reserve our programs. So just give me 1 second. All right, Meredith, all yours.
Thank you. Hi, friends. Glad to see all of you here tonight, and we appreciate you being with us. Just give me a moment while I share my screen so I can share where you can find a little bit more about all of our programs and what you would need to think about and plan on to arrange for us to visit you. Okay, I've taken you here to the MODS website. This is a website I'm sure many of you are familiar with, having partnered with the museum in the past to support your learning experiences inside and outside the classroom. To make things easy right now, especially during this crazy COVID time, we've done a little bit of rearranging to our website, and I just wanted to show this to share how easy it is to find everything that you would need that would be relevant to connecting with MODS for any of your classroom needs. So if you go to our website, you can simply click on virtual learning and scroll down to educators. And once you click there, you will land on this page that I'm on now that gives you more information about everything that we've covered tonight and also allows you to connect with our educator guide. I know many of you are accustomed to getting your annual educator guide from us via the school system pony or in the mail. And you know, we've done it a little differently this year. We are completely digital, and we're doing that so that we can ensure we're bringing you the latest and greatest programming and making those kinds of adjustments that we're all having to make right now to best meet the needs of our learners and be the most relevant that we can be, knowing that things are really changing daily with us. So if you click on the educator guide button, it will take you to bear with me here. Our 2020-2021 Educator Guide. Now, this is just designed in page turning software to make it easy for you to thumb through and find what you need. A few changes I wanted to point out. I know you all can all look at this at your own leisure and more comfortably in your yoga pants at home later on if you're thinking about connecting with us. But a few things I wanted to share if you're thinking about planning a program with MODS. On the first sheet here, you see very simple ways to connect with us. Booking at mods.net is one of the easiest ways to connect with us if you just have some general questions about the educator guide and what you're seeing there, and of course our general phone number. We also have forms that can be filled out if you have a little bit more details planned out with regards to what you want that experience to look like. You can simply start the booking process through our website. So what you'll notice here, and you've heard referenced this evening, I think Joe very, very much emphasized it early on in our program, our new Inspire model. And that really is designed to meet the needs of your learners in a virtual setting. And so you'll see here the snapshot of each one of those programs that our team highlighted this evening. And you'll see you know, the approximate length of time for those programs, as well as a range of learners that we're suggesting for those programs. This is simply a guide. I wanted to point that out, that these are recommendations of ours, but certainly, especially during this crazy time, we are making custom programming and certainly modifying things as we need to meet your learners' needs. So for example, a lot of the things you'll see here are built for a classroom. I know often we do programming for an entire grade level. So if that is of interest to you, please know that all of these programs are very adaptable, not only by age range, but also by group size. We can find a way to meet the needs of whatever size learning group you have. So please just know that this is a guide for us. And what's also nice about our Inspire program is it can be arranged to be an a la carte program, really offering one of those activities that our team highlighted tonight, whether it's a maker kit program or a tour. But it can also be designed to serve as really a full school day field trip. So we've built it that way so that it would lay out to really run similarly to what an on-site experience would be at the museum. And you'll see here some pricing for those different models, whether it's an a la carte model or something that's more of a half day, full school day field trip experience. Now, we also know that early learning centers are going out and about, and we also have a lot of great relationships with our private schools in the area. So I didn't want to pass over our on-site experiences. We continue to offer our on-site experiences at the museum. And what's so really wonderful about them now, if you do have the ability to take your learners outside of the classroom space, is that we are closed for public hours at the museum until the beginning of the calendar year. And so you have the full museum to yourself if you book an on-site experience with us. That means that your group of learners who are always together would be the only ones in the museum for their program. So I wanted to highlight that as well. And then what you'll notice this year too, if you look at the top left and right of the page, we've organized our guide to really be to serve as chapters by age group. So here we're in the early childhood chapter of our educator guide, and you'll see on the left our on-site offerings and on the right the Inspire offerings. And we did this just to make it really simple. So if this is the age group you're looking at with regards to meeting your classroom needs, this is a one-stop shop. You don't have to flip through the book to find what you need. It's all in this section. And you'll see as we advance, here is K-2, same thing, on-site, off-site, 3-5, six through eight, and then of course our high school learners. And as Becky mentioned, we have experimented a lot with our activity kits, and they are certainly appropriate for all ages. I have, this summer I had a four-year-old son who used those kits for a birthday party I hosted for him, and they were just as popular for him as they were for my nephews who are teenagers that I mailed them to. So the kits are really flexible in that way, and depending on the instruction can certainly be modeled to meet the needs of any age group learners. And what I also wanted to point out that would be new this year is we have partnered with our friends at IMAX. And we have an entire film library now that can be streamed directly to your classroom or going through Teams or Zoom to your learners should they be at home. So it's the library is here. You can see it's our Inspire IMAX film library. And it's been set up so that you really can get a taste for each one of these films by simply clicking on the image here, and it takes you directly to the preview trailer of those films. And if you wanted any additional information or you wanted some teacher materials, we're happy to send that if you do not see it connected here on the link. But this will give you a great overview as to the content of the film, and most of these films have supporting educational content that we can share as well. So again, this can be part of a half-day Inspire program, or you can just choose to add one of these films to some programming you're already doing in the classroom. And then of course, our IMAX is open at MODS, and we have a full range of films playing. I wanted to highlight recently released and then an upcoming release that we're expecting in our IMAX. And I also wanted to point out here, these are all films that are in our IMAX library. So if you are able to come on site, just know that we're able to reserve the IMAX for your group and put on in any one of these films that are available in our library. You can click on these as well to be able to go and access the trailer for the films. The one I wanted to highlight tonight is Dinosaurs of the Antarctica. It is an amazing film. It's the first dinosaur film that's been released by IMAX in over 10 years. And it's a nice complement to a lot of the dinosaur programming we have at MODS. Right now, we actually have a dinosaur exhibit that's gonna be with us until the first of the year. And new, coming soon, is Into America's Wild. This is a fantastic film that really takes you places on the earth that you might not have ever been. So bear with me here as I transition to Dinosaurs of the Antarctica, because this is the one that we are currently showing, so you can get a taste for how the film is done.
It's the coldest, windiest place on Earth. But Antarctica's wilderness was not always frozen. Discover an ancient realm of midnight suns, night hunters and river monsters. A prehistoric kingdom lost to time and ice. Join a new generation of scientists on an Antarctic adventure to uncover a hidden dinosaur story. A cinematic journey from today's frozen desert to a lush South Polar world of giants. Welcome to the dinosaur continent of Gondwana. Welcome to Antarctica.
And by clicking on these images, you're able to get that same preview for all of our films in the library. And of course, this highlights the museum floor experience, all of our exhibits on both floors of the museum, as well as our outdoor science park. We do have a traveling exhibit coming this summer, Here Be Dragons, that I wanted to mention briefly. It's a beautiful exhibit, and we're excited to be bringing it to MODS in May. So if you are looking for a fun way to be able to get out of the house with your family, we would love to have you over the summer come and visit us when that exhibit is here. And I also wanted to touch on this. I know many teachers are regular consumers of this, but it surprises me to hear how oftentimes a lot of educators are not aware of this, but the museum has a very long-standing partnership with Beacon TV. And Beacon and MODS have been working together to do distance learning programs far before COVID was even a term. And We have a library that we put together with Beacon every year, and it consists of a monthly program, 10 months of the year. Those programs are streamed live directly to the classroom, so you're able to access those live for your learners, and the learners are able to connect with us and ask questions live. And so that's a really awesome component of that program. You'll see here, we lay out the themes for the year in advance, so you know in advance what we're going to be covering. Sometimes we have guest presenters, but it's a really nice way to be able to bring in that level of interaction into your classroom with these standing programs. And of course, if you can't make the standing program, all of these are recorded by Beacon and become part of the library that you can access at a later time. And then while we're on this page, I also wanted to mention that we have several programs that would be available through grant funding that the museum secures to potentially be able to come out to your school based on qualification. We have some programming that is free. We have, for example, our health program, Wise Bodies, that's going to be released in video format in December that is free to all high school and middle schools. That we'll be pushing out and putting on Canvas. We also have a really amazing space program that is available to Title I schools. And the list goes on and on. So we certainly work to secure funding to be able to support students in the community. So please connect with us if you have a question about perhaps how we would be able to visit your school. And I wanna mention this. I'm not quite sure exactly where it's landed, but we were told that perhaps field trip funding would remain in place for schools and that schools perhaps would be able to draw down on those this year through the district to be able to participate in virtual experiences. So I'm not quite sure if that's been finalized, but we certainly had heard word that was being worked on. So I would encourage you all, if you had previously accessed field trip funding through the district, to reach out if you're interested and see how you can use some of that to be able to invite mods. And as Missy touched on, we have an awesome Family Science Night program that can really be modeled for what you want to accomplish. And it doesn't have to be at night. And then I didn't want to leave out that we have an awesome educator membership program. It's $10 for educators. We have a special family rate that would allow you to have up to 6 people on your membership for $100, which is a $45 discount off of our standard membership. And it's just our very small way of saying thank you for all you do for the students and children in our community, and that we very much appreciate your partnership and love working with you. So please take advantage of that. It's as simple as showing your school ID and we will get you signed up.
Hi. What's that? Yes. Okay.
And that's it for me. I'm gonna turn it back over.
More for the gym has, high tech because they're new. And I know the park and packing, they have some, they caught some vandalism recently on their video. That little corner one, points right here to these two vehicles. The Lauderdale police have been in here, asking questions. I don't know, what is that black hole? That was just put in.
All right, thank you, Meredith, for sharing all the good information with us. Just so you guys know, if you want to contact us really easily, this just email booking@mods.com. And like Meredith said, you can visit our website for more information about everything. So yeah. All right. So we already talked about this. All right. So I think now Joe's going to tell us more about our upcoming programs. Joe, you're muted.
Thanks. Sorry, I was still muted. Sorry about that. A few more things to share with everyone. While we understand that there are lots of different ways to learn right now, one of the things that we are offering here at the museum is our Mods Pods. And this is an opportunity for local learners. So this is for Broward County Public Schools students, kindergarten through fifth grade, to come to the museum and log in to the BCPS e-learning program. We have very strict guidelines and limited numbers, 9 children and 1 educator per classroom. So this might be a great thing if you have students whose parents have to go to work. We do have scholarships available for kindergarten through third grade students for children who are attending Title I schools and whose families may be EBT card holders. So booking at mods.net, again, booking at mods.net is something you'll want to remember through the rest of this presentation and into the future. Thank you, Eric. Coming soon, we have our Wise Bodies presented by AHF, AIDS Healthcare Foundation. We do have a virtual program right now that is available. And on December 1st, we're going to be launching another version of the program. And eventually, we will even be able to come back to your schools to deliver this program. It's a high school program that really addresses HIV, AIDS, and STDs, also touches on COVID. This is just a really critical program for teens in high school, and we want to make sure that they are as safe as possible in their lives. So we're happy to present that program free of charge to any middle or high school program. Thanks, Eric. Now, as Meredith said, we work very closely with Broward County Public Schools. They're a wonderful partner for us to have. And we wanted to share some of the programs that we're doing together. And this is one that Broward County Public Schools have been doing for a long time with the Broward County Department of Environmental Protection. And that's NatureScape. There are all kinds of virtual versions, including the P3 Eco Challenge, which are happening ongoing. And the Youth Climate Summit this year is going to be virtual as well. And I'll share a slide on that in a moment. But if we can move on, please, Eric. The Broward County Public School STEM Challenges. Check out the website here. And if you move your, depending on where you have your video views, but on the extreme right-hand side of this slide is a QR code. If you scan that QR code, it will actually take you to the Broward STEM Challenges site. There are some great challenges going on, all virtual. We're partnering with Broward County Public Schools and Broward County on these. We'd really encourage your students to check out these challenges, some fun activities, and coming soon, there'll be a Mods Challenge presented by the Extra Catch. So more on that in the coming months. So the Youth Climate Summit. Last year, the Youth Climate Summit welcomed over 900 students here to Mods. This year, it's going to be virtual. Starting soon and over the coming months, there are going to be virtual modules. And then in March of next year, the Youth Climate Summit will be 3 days of virtual programming that students will be able to attend. Really great lineup of events happening, addressing climate change resiliency. This year's theme is global challenges, regional implications, and local actions. We all know that students are passionate about climate change and resiliency. It's something near and dear to our heart here at Mods. So this is coming into next year. Thank you. Now, before we get to our prizes, I know we have some questions that have been going into the chat. Does anyone else have any questions? I saw one that was in the chat. I'm teaching virtually. is there any way to have kits delivered to families? Missy pointed out that we can actually deliver the kits to the school, and then the students can pick them up from there. So any other questions that may have come up during this evening? So I wanna again thank all of the Mods team. Becky took us in detail learning about Inspire and mentioned a little thing that she's passionate about, the STEMmobile. So more on the STEMmobile coming soon. Remember that booking at mods.net is how you get in touch with us. And we are hosting on-site field trips here at Mods. So we're excited to really engage with you. Our mission, connecting to people, connecting people to inspiring science. We can do that here or we can do that virtually. So Eric, I think it's time for our prizes.
I think so too, but I just wanted to jump in with one question that a couple people messaged me during our presentation. I understand that we're recording this whole session and some people join late or they have people who weren't able to make it tonight. Is there some way they'll be able to access the recording once we're done?
There is. We are going to, after we've recorded this, I believe we're going to be sharing this on YouTube and we'll probably share it on our Facebook page as well. So if you don't follow us on Facebook, please do. And visit the Mods YouTube page as well, which is Mods FTL, I believe.
Yes. Okay, on to the fun stuff.
Okay, prizes. Now, Eric, I'm going to ask if you don't mind to pop back to the prize page. And I've got some questions lined up. So the first question this evening, and what I'm going to do is we are going to ask that you write in the chat. So the first question this evening is an Inspire virtual program that will be delivered to you. So the question here is, what is the name of our new outreach STEMmobile? Oh. There we go, Nicole, STEMmobile. So Nicole, who teaches fourth grade science, congratulations. I will try not to give away the answer in the next question. So,
Can I interrupt you for a quick second? Nicole, if you will write your contact information in the chat so we know how to get a hold of you, that would be terrific.
Thank you, Meredith. And Nicole, if you can select to Eric in the chat. And oh, there you go. We've got your information. Thank you so much for your school. It's going to get an Inspire program. Up next. What is the four-letter nickname of the museum? What do people call us? Good job, wow. Okay, so let's see, go up to the top. I think Surf Skate Science got the first correct answer with Mods. So the representative from Surf Skate Science, great name by the way, if you could put your contact information in the chat, we will make sure that you get two Hollywood IMAX tickets. Up next, we are going to give away the Explore Store Mystery Box. So the Explore Store Mystery Box is going to whoever knows which email you should use if you have questions or if you want to book a program. Let's see, if you want to book a program, where would you send that?
Booking Modes.
Let's see. I think Jennifer Alvarez, bookings@mods.net. Sorry, I think I might want to double check that. It's booking@mods.net. So, Sandra DaCosta, booking@mods.net. Thank you so much. Now, we have a maker activity kit, which will be shipped to you. And for this next question, can you name the baby alligator that we saw in the video? Wow, Nicole, you are quick with the typing. Good job, Nicole, beast boy. Now, if you would like to have Beast Boy or one of our other animals visit you here at in your classroom with your learners, how much would you pay for a teacher membership? Lots of people paying attention. But Charlene, if you would like to pay $100, we're happy to have that donation. Thank you. So let's see, Jennifer Alvarez, $10. So congratulations. Again, thank you so much to all of our educators. We really appreciate what you do for children in our community or further afield in Staten Island and beyond. Now, this is an incredibly hard time, but please know that the Museum of Discovery and Science is here to help you each and every day. We'd love to be able to bring some of our programs to you. So please feel free to reach out, explore the educator guide. Again, to our incredible team here at the museum, thank you. Really appreciate all that you do as well. So unless there are any other questions from everyone, thank you so much for joining us and have a great night. Thanks, everyone.
Bye, guys. Have a good night. Thanks for joining us.
Bye. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Bye.